So NinjaTrader released 8.1.1.0, which in my opinion was a complete cluster. And then they released 8.1.1.1, which resolved some major issues. They're heading in the right direction. You might want to reserve on updating. You might not, because there are some features that became more expensive, but some that became cheaper as well. So stay tuned. Think about what's making you afraid. There's nobody in the world who's ever wanted to fail, but a little bit of help can get you on your way. XABCD is where you can start today. Okay, so let me give you a bit of a quick update here. NinjaTrader had done a whole rebranding thing, and they only told vendors about it a week before the release, but they didn't let anyone try it out. The release happened, and a lot of vendors had issues with licensing, or we had issues with certain bugs that were in the software that apparently wasn't supposed to be code breaking, but was. Okay, that has all been fixed. Okay, so you can go to 8.1.1.1 and you can use it as normal in that regards. Now, what has happened? So back on December 5th, 2022, NinjaTrader filed their new trademark for all their new branding. And then in January, they bought Tradovate, which obviously was going to fill their needs of a web platform and mobile app and rebrand it as NinjaTrader. We were expecting this, and we mentioned this in our last update video, that there were going to be some big changes based off what was already public, which was their whole trademark that was done in December. Big disappointment. Wish I could tell you what it was. Probably not allowed, but that should mean the next one is going to be really big. However, we didn't see that. What we saw was that happened with 8.1, and that was what caught everybody by surprise, because NinjaTrader didn't tell anyone that they were doing this, and vendors were not informed, or they were not allowed to test it. So a lot of things happened during the 8.1 release that probably could have been avoided should they allow the vendors to test it. What matters to you now is going forward, what has fixed and what has changed, as well as what features are new there. And you probably notice a lot of the rebranding stuff that has taken place. So this is a breakdown of that. Now, not all changes are bad. For instance, one of the good changes are, if you use NinjaTrader for free and you just pay a higher commission, you get access to what they called the Trader Plus before, which is essentially ATMs and basically the full suite of products. So that is a welcome change, because a lot of people were being sucked into a broker's account, getting a free license key. However, after that, they were up the creek, because they realized that they couldn't do the basic things that they thought they could, like use an ATM. Okay, so NinjaTrader came out with a different pricing structure, and I think it works for a lot of people. I think it makes sense. You have your super, let's call them super cheap people. we're gonna label you as, here's a free license, and you can now use all the features. So before, you weren't able to use ATMs. This is how they got you to upgrade. Now you get access to everything, and you have your free copy of NinjaTrader. You're just going to pay a higher commission side for your trading. And it's not that bad, but it is going to be higher. So if you're just learning and you're trying to figure out if you want to pay for this over time or not, or if you want a lifetime license, you want to check it out first, there is that free option. So I think that's great. Then there's a monthly option. You pay $100 and your commissions are substantially reduced. So it depends on how much you trade and how active you are. It might or might not be worth it to you. And then there are those who really want a lot of value. You're going to pay $1,500. It's going to be a lifetime license. That was increased from, I think it was $1,200. Don't quote me. But I still think that's pretty cheap. I mean, here's how I justify it, okay? $1,500. It is going to be $100 a month for 15 months. And then it's all your updates and everything else are totally free. You don't pay anything for it. And you have a much lower commission for every round contract. So I don't think it's that bad. My monitors on my desk cost more than that. I have to replace them every 6 years. This is $1,500. It's a one-time payment and all your updates are included. So that's how I justify it. But yeah, that is their new structure for their pricing. Now, they have released a NinjaTrader app, and they've done this for iPhone and Android. I looked at it. I wasn't like too impressed with it. I'm not using NinjaTrader trying to chart on my phone. I think that that's a poor approach in general. So I'm not using it for that, but I think for people who have a brokerage account with NinjaTrader and want to be able to manage their orders, I think that's good to have a mobile app for. So I think that that's a pro. Now, the other side was the web application that they came out with, which is basically their Tradovay acquisition. It does not allow you to use third-party indicators that were on the desktop now on the web platform. And I think that's going to be a bit of a challenge for them. Now they have to convince everyone to create in different coding language the indicators for the web version and how many people are going to pick that up and whatnot. But that web version solves NinjaTrader's management issues with not having a Mac version. And again, I really hope they never create software for the Mac, because I think it would take away the resources that they've been able to spend on the development of their platform that they have right now. Because running it in NinjaTrader on VMware on a Mac with Fusion is actually really good. I mean, we did a whole video on it. It has, you know, a lot of popular feedback on it. So I think that works, and really it's pretty inexpensive. So
easy and painless. It's going to look like that. So it's probably what you want, what you expect, and that's what you're going to kind of get. You can set this all up for 30 days. It's absolutely free.
But yeah, overall, I think that having the web application and the app is a good step in the right direction. This is their first release, so you can bet it's going to have a lot of bugs, and it's going to probably take a little bit of fine tuning and more features to be added to it. So eventually it's going to be in the right direction, but I still think most people are probably going to use an NinjaTrader desktop app over something like the web or the app, you know, obviously, unless you're using the app for order management. Now, one thing that did change are the brokers that you're allowed to use with NinjaTrader after March 3rd. If you had purchased NinjaTrader before, you can still use all the same ones, but afterwards, you're going to be limited to a subset. I guess some of these contracts didn't make sense for companies to renew based off the whole rebranding. So I imagine that might have something to do with it, but you are going to have limited data providers and brokerages now. Hopefully this list will be expanded. I don't like it shrinking. I'd rather it be bigger. So hopefully we'll see that. 389 and 401 is mainly going to fix a lot of third-party indicators and problems that they had with licensing or running their software. So those two issues would allow you to upgrade to 8.1 and not have any issues with the indicators. Now, remember, 8.1 in the release was all about rebranding. It wasn't about fixing things. So there's limited fixes that are going to be involved with the platform itself. It's more to do with the rebranding efforts. So 390 fixed the Google and Apple logins that when you clicked on them, you wouldn't be able to log in. It was really super annoying when 8.1 came out. This is why you want to go 8.1.1.1. And then 399 was a login error that was not removed when you attempted to log in again and again and again. Now, I don't know if this had something to do with the threshold that they have. But it now, if you make too many wrong attempts, and I'll have to find out what that number is, it tells you to wait an hour and to log in again. Now, I can see this being a real issue, so I don't know if there's a way around it. But when you don't allow someone to save a password and then they have to type it in, they think they're entering the right one and it's not, and then you lock them out and you can't get in anymore, you know, this is going to be an issue, I think. So hopefully they find a way to resolve that, whether or not there's like a code that gets sent to your email and then you enter that code and then it unlocks it automatically. You don't have to wait the hour. That I would like to see changed. Also 626 with this login window. They fixed the whole username was not being remembered. But obviously the password is still an issue. So the fix was for the username to be remembered, but not for the password. I think they're looking into things like that. They added an indicator for like a loader, so you can see that the software is actually doing something, but it would be nice if they had a save password button. So just a quick note, we've been doing these release videos since the early initial NT8 releases. Now over 100 videos have been done. Now, I've been thinking about redoing all the tutorial ones on 8.1 and updating them, showing more examples and ways to use all the features. And as sad as it might be, your interaction with these videos and all those comments, thumbs up, to everything else that you guys have the ability to do is what actually motivates me to keep doing these. So if you can show me a little love by whacking that thumbs up button, let me know that you do find these videos useful and you want me to continue these, I'll pump out another 150 over the next few years on 8.1 showing you all those examples. Now, in exchange, there are four things we've created for our awesome YouTube community. The first is a collection of ATM packs. And the reason why you want this is because they are more advanced templates than what you probably have, like trailing stops in three different steps in case you get a sudden unexpected move in the market and you want to lock in those gains. I believe there are around a dozen entry and stop strategies that you can modify for your existing execution plans. And the second thing we have is a news indicator, which we use. It's mainly used so that news doesn't sneak up on you. And of course, when volatility might hit the market suddenly and that you're aware of it ahead of time. The next is the periodic table, and it shows you all the elements and traits that we believe successful traders have, and each is explained in a whole reference PDF with an awesome little printable thing at the end. Now, the last, of course, is our price line indicator, which has a whole bunch of cool effects that make your eyes look at where price currently is in the market. And of course, the last thing I want to tell you that you can go to any of our webpages at xabcdtrading.com. And at the very bottom, you can put your name and email if you want to stay up to date on the project. There is a maximum of 2 emails a month that get sent out. Some months, I think last one was only 1. And sometimes we don't send out any. But it's going to be a maximum of 2, and you'll get all the updates around all these different projects that we're working on. So take advantage of all the free stuff, and we'll see you in the next video. Think about what's making you afraid. There's nobody in the world who's ever wanted to fail, but a little bit of help can get you on your way. XABCD is where you can start today.